2017 be a big year for tech IPOs? So far, we've seen, well, a few come to mark volatile debut, of course, for Snap. But since, there have been a few companies looking to the public market. Earlier, we spoke exclusively to Vinod Khosla, founder of Khosla Ventures, and Bipul Sinha, partner at Lightspeed Ventures and Rubrik CEO. I immediately asked, well, is now the time to go public? Lightspeed Ventures was the first institution to financially back Snap, and Khosla was an investor in Okta, which of course is on the lineup to list. Take a listen.
I wouldn't say so. What we are seeing is that high quality companies with a real business model and sustainability or path to profitability and long-term sustainability are the companies that are going public. Not every company is going public. So it feels like the bar still is high, but we have a number of companies with that high quality revenues, earnings, differentiated product that are getting into the marketplace.
And so when you have your viewpoint on as chief executive as Rubrik, looking at all these enterprise companies that have followed on from Snap, which was a consumer-based company, now it's the time of enterprise. Is it time for Rubrik to start looking at the public markets? What really drives the sentiment there?
We are probably 2 years away from the public market, but we are building a company to become a public company and long-term sustainable business. I think fundamentals of enterprise business and selling into larger part or larger end of the market and deriving six-figure, seven-figure, eight-figure deals is what drives the enterprise business. So we are at Rubrik focused on like Fortune 500 global 2000 companies where they have real needs around cloud, around data orchestration, data management, data security, and where Rubrik plays.
But when you're looking at your portfolio companies, I mean, we see some really big juggernauts that already have a proven business model, already are bringing in revenues, already international. You just have to think of Uber and Airbnb, Dropbox. What needs to happen? Do these companies need to come to the market? Do you think it's up to the investor base, the VCs, to say the time is now, or do you quite like companies remaining private?
The choice of whether a company stays private or goes public is entirely in entrepreneurs. Okay. There's a lot more flexibility as a private company to do some things. When you get to the public markets, you need to be predictable. You need to set out long-term goals. Entrepreneurial companies like Rubrik change strategy continuously, iterate, adjust. They're a very young company. It's only 3 years old. And so you want that flexibility to change. And with private investors, it's much easier to do. When you get to a highly predictable stage, then the entrepreneur can choose to go public or not. We always support the entrepreneur in their choice.
So you never apply any pressure?
Almost never, really. It's the wrong thing to do, apply pressure.
But you don't need exits. You don't need to give money back to the LPs. You must have your own needs.
You know, I'm proud of the fact that we never worry about exits. They happen when they happen. They happen often enough, but we almost never worry about it. In fact, I have a rule, if somebody talks about exits when we are investing, we won't invest in a company that talks about exits.
Fascinating.
It's the wrong approach to building really durable, large companies, thinking about exits. I'd much rather have somebody like Bipul or Nutanix trying to build really large companies over the long haul. And whether you get liquidity in a year or in 4 years, it almost doesn't matter if you're building real value.
You were saying before, Vinod, that you are an optimist. And we have cloud as a driver, we have data as a driver. I want to know about some of the environments in which we work within Silicon Valley right now, though, and whether they help foster optimism or not, particularly when it comes to the new administration and when it comes to perhaps the second iteration of the travel ban. I sit here with two Indian gentlemen. I'm a Brit as well. But do you worry about perhaps the limitations to some of the immigration US will see?
I do worry about it. If people like Bipul can't start a company here, they'll move operations to India. Mm. We're starting to see more and more people talking about building outside because if they can't acquire the talent here. For educated talent, there's global competition. Canada is dying to get more of this talent. You know, just the National Foundation for American Policy just issued a little thing, said 83% of the finalists in Intel science talent competition were born to immigrant parents. Think about it, 83%. immigrants, especially the well-educated ones, really, really, and frankly, all immigrants, renew a country. And countries that have gone into stasis like Japan did so because they were so insular. So I actually believe it's a huge advantage. It's been the source of growth in America and the growth of vibrancy.
But Bipul, you're a man growing, obviously, the headquarters in Silicon Valley, but you're also growing internationally. Is this something that worries you? How has it affected your business here, or do you look to perhaps just have hubs elsewhere?
For us, the way we look at it is that these politics and these kind of rules will take care of itself. I believe that our country, the fundamentals are very strong. In America, we have the transactional governance, we have rule of law, we have a structure that fosters innovation. So I view this as like a transient phenomena where over time things will take care of itself. When we go international, we do business in like probably 30 odd countries right now. And so far we have not seen any headwind in our growth or any kind of backlash because of it.
H-1B visa, is that something you've deployed or used? And
so we use H-1B visa on case by case basis. And obviously H-1B visa is a challenge because there is a lottery system and very few people can get it. So we take a comprehensive strategy of where we get talent pool from and how we grow the talent pool. And we are cognizant of the restriction around H-1, the number of H-1 applicants available, things like that. But we are thinking about this business as a long-term self-sustaining business with our sales and marketing around the world. And we are looking at innovation and saying that how do we continue to drive innovation and bring people together on this mission to go change the data management platform for multi-cloud world.
As VCs, with your VC hat on too, Bipul, where excites you the most geographically? Where do you want Khosla Ventures to be keeping an eye on if it's not just Silicon Valley?
Well, outside of Silicon Valley, there's plenty of exciting things going on in like Europe. Israel, India, China, of course, is a whole different beast. We tend not to do a lot in China, but there's interesting technological things happening.
Why
there
don't too. You with China?
Just we have a geographic focus, and so we feel we don't understand how to do business in China.